Good evening. Welcome back to my live at home concerts. I'm gonna start tonight with a prelude in B flat major from the first book of the Well-Tempered Clavier by Johann Sebastian Bach. I have to say, I'm really, really excited about playing this for you. I have been thinking about playing that piece for you guys for the last week or so, as I was doing other things. This is absolutely gorgeous, beautiful piece of work that for some or other reason fits my DNA perfectly. I love this piece. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. This is so special. Very compact, very small. This is Bach going into the 21st century. Except he wasn't anywhere close to that. But Bach's oldest son, Carl Philipp Emanuel, is the one who wrote Solfeggiato. And in this composition, the Bach's writing style is very much close to his oldest son. And Bach believed that his oldest son is a better composer than himself, which he was kind of wrong about, because although Carl Philipp is very inventive, was, I should have said, inventive, creative, and wonderful composer, he is no way match for Johann Sebastian, for the Papa Bach. Papa Bach is everything. Next, I'm gonna play a composition by Wayne Shorter, which I don't often do because a lot of them really heavily require a band to play with. This one is called Black Nile, and I'm gonna make it musical, I'm hoping. I hope you enjoy Black Nile. Thank you. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed that little detour into insanity. Black Nile, Wayne Shorter. Next piece I'm going to play is called In My Own Sweet Way, and it is Dave Brubeck, and I'm always remembering his own recording of this, and then Keith Jarrett did the recording of this, and in both cases it's an interesting harmonic progression. It's a bit unusual, and it's interesting how to make the life flow through this construction that Dave Brubeck invented. I hope you enjoy In Your Own Sweet Way. Thank you. I'm thinking that that probably meant for me to play this song in my own sweet way, right? Hi, Dave. Wait. I've seen Brubeck live. He's one of the very few people from that generation and from that level of musicianship that I actually have seen live. And he was somewhat older at the time and very well established. Played some of his compositions. Two of his kids, I believe, played with him. And I remember that one of the solos that he played on something more like more swinging, more traditional thing, and he played the heck out of that piano. That man was as old as dirt, and his swinging and his energy level were at 99%. It was he was as excited as the 14-year-old would be when he first discovers the blues scale. Speaking of which, I'm gonna finish tonight with a little piece, that is called the centerpiece. Centerpiece. It's not the same with centrifuge or what was the other one? Anyways, it's called the centerpiece. So I'm thinking it's thinking of the ice swan in the middle of the table or something of that. Centerpiece. I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you. Centerpiece. It actually has subtitle there that says Easter Parade. So it's bigger than the Frozen Swan. It's the centerpiece. I hope you enjoyed tonight. And please do come back tomorrow. I will be here playing some more music.